morning. Thank you so much to the Edelweiss Musikanten for being here this morning and for welcoming us with your beautiful music. Welcome to all of you this morning. A special welcome to our honorary guests, and I'm just picking out one this morning. Among us is Vice Consul General Mr. Stocker, for the very first time here at St. Mark's. So welcome here at the church, welcome at St. Mark's. Thank you for being here. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Let us begin with a time of silent reflection. Together we pray, most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we are dead to sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with the power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Holy God, we long for your peace and trust in your promise. We hear your call to turn towards you, to change our lives and to welcome you in. Meet us here and fill our minds with your wisdom and our hearts with your peace, that our worship together may open us to the challenge of your dream of wholeness for all. We pray this in the name of the one who is coming, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We are now going to welcome Pastor Ingrid into her role as transitional pastor of St. Mark's Lutheran Church, and I'm asking everyone who will be involved to step forward and to come here. Liest du mit Jason da?
Ich lese Worte aus dem 1. Timotheusbrief, 4. Kapitel. Niemand verachte deine Jugend, sondern sei ein Vorbild den Gläubigen, in Wort, im Wandel, in der Liebe, im Glauben, in der Reinheit. Haltet an mit Lesen, mit Ermahnen, mit Lehren, bis ich komme. Lass nicht außer Acht die Gabe in dir, die dir gegeben ist, durch Weissagung mit Handauflegung der Ältesten. Dies lass deine Sorge sein, damit gehe um, auf das dein Zunehmen allen offenbar werde. Habe Acht auf dich selbst, auf die Lehre, beharre in diesen Stücken, denn wenn du solches tust, wirst du dich selbst retten und die, die dich hören. Der Herr segne sein Wort an uns.
In John chapter 20, we hear, Jesus again said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I'm sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." The word of God, the word of life. Amen.
Pastor Ingrid, in the presence of this congregation, will you commit yourself to the new trust and responsibilities, the promise to discharge your duties in harmony with the Constitution and bylaws of this congregation?
Yes, with the help of God.
Will you love, serve, and pray for these people of God, nourishing them with the Word and the Holy Sacraments, and lead them in the use of the means of grace?
Yes, with the help of God.
Will you lead this people of God in giving faithful witness to the world and making known the love of God through loving service in this community?
Yes, with the help of God.
Almighty God, who has given you the will to do these things, gives you the power of his Spirit so that you may perform them with strength and compassion. congregation. Amen.
Amen.
And you, people of God, will you receive this messenger of Jesus Christ, who continues the work of bringing the gospel of hope and salvation? Will you regard her as a servant of Christ and a steward of the mysteries of God? Then answer, we will.
We will.
Will you pray for her and honor her for her work's sake? In all things, things strive to live together in the peace and unity of Christ. Then answer, we will.
We will.
By your statements of commitment and the affirmation of this congregation, we welcome you as our traditional pastor of this congregation. May the Lord pour out unto you his Spirit, Holy Spirit, for the work committed to you, that you may faithfully proclaim the gospel in word and sacraments. Go, then take up the word to which you have been called.
Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, you have blessed and sustained us for many years. You have given us this life together in a Christian community of this congregation. Be with us now, we pray, as we enter this in-between time, and welcome Pastor Ingrid as transitional pastor. Bless us and guide us as we prepare for the next stage in this congregation's life. Give us courage, patience, and vision, and strengthen our vocation of witness in the world and service to others. We ask your blessing upon the work of Pastor Ingrid. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon her and provide her with wisdom, compassion, and discernment for the work that needs to be done and the witness of your grace she is called to give. Let us all grow closer to you day by day and understand the love and grace more deeply. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please.
The first lesson is taken from the Old Testament, from the book of the prophet Malachi 3, chapter 1 to 4. God, who rules over all, says, I will send my messenger. He will prepare my way for me. Then suddenly the Lord you're looking for will come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant will come. He is the one you long for. But who can live through the day when he comes? Who will be left standing when he appears? He'll be like a fire that makes things pure. He'll be like soap that makes things clean. He will act like one who makes silver pure, and he will purify the Levites just as gold and silver are purified with fire. Then these men will bring proper offerings to the Lord, and the offerings of Judah and Jerusalem will be acceptable to him. It will be as it was in days and years gone by, The word of God, word of life.
Gemeinschaft mit Christus aus Philipper 2, 1 bis 5. Der Apostel Paulus schreibt: Ist nun bei euch Ermahnung in Christus, ist Trost der Liebe, ist Gemeinschaft des Geistes, ist herzliche Liebe und Barmherzigkeit. So macht meine Freude dadurch vollkommen, dass ihr eines Sinnes seid. Gleiche Liebe habt, einmütig und einträchtig seid. Tut nichts aus Eigennutz oder um eitler Ehre willen, sondern in Demut. In Demut achte einer den anderen höher als sich selbst, und ein jeder sehe nicht auf das Seine, sondern auch auf das, was dem anderen dient. Seid so unter euch gesinnt, wie es der Gemeinschaft in Christus Jesus entspricht. The Word of God, the Word of Life.
The Gospel according to Luke, chapter 3. Glory to you, O Lord. It was the 15th year of the rule of Emperor Tiberius. Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea. King Herod was ruler of Galilee, and his brother Philip was ruler of the territory of Iturea. Annas and Caiaphas were high priests in Jerusalem. At that time, the word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the desert. So John went throughout the whole territory of the Jordan River preaching, "Turn away from your sins. Repent, and God will forgive your sins." As it is written in the book of the prophet Isaiah, "Someone is shouting in the desert, 'Get the road ready for the Lord, make a straight path for him to travel. Every valley must be filled up, every hill and mountain leveled off. The winding roads must be made straight and the rough paths made smooth. The whole human race will see God's salvation. Word of God, word of life. Praise to you, O Christ. And we continue by singing, just look into your bulletins, please. Okay, I think it's working. Grace be with you. And let me continue. And with him who is, who was, and who will come again, Jesus Christ. Amen. And thank you for welcoming me so warmly this morning. And here we are now. Transitional time, transitional pastor. Sounds a little bit weird, doesn't it? But I think together, we will go through this time and together we'll make it. So it's the year 2021, and it's the 15th year of the government of Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, the fourth year of Premier John Horgan in BC, when German Chancellor Angela Merkel is about to retire, and Pastor Hardo Ermisch already has retired. A man is crying in the wilderness, asking that you are to change, and then change the world, so that Christ can come. Are we listening to the words? It was John, whom we call the Baptist, whose message each of us shall hear. John was unique. Quite frankly, he made his home in the wilderness, a desert-like wasteland. He separated himself from society. He nourished on grasshoppers and honey. The honey thing I can understand, but grasshoppers? Quite a diet, don't you think? He wore simple clothing. He got back to the basics. And the word of God came to John. In the desert, not to the emperor, not to the king, even not to the religious authorities, but John. God chose a nobody to prepare the way for God's Son to come among us. And you know, the majority of the biblical people, including Jesus, were not, by and large, history's winners. They were persecuted. They were dislocated, enslaved, desperate. They lived, as some of you did, through famine, war, and natural disaster. And they suffered starvation and violence and exile and genocide, and they were in countless ways the wretched of the earth, brave, lonely voices crying in the desert. And they cried out their yearning for a better world and their sorrow and their pain and their fear. But here's the remarkable thing. They also cried their hope. Their fierce, strong hope in a God who cares, in a God who saves. And the word John cried was, repent. I know that repent and repentance are loaded words. I know that some of us are suspicious of these words for good reasons. They are words which have been used often to frighten and to diminish us and to proclaim a revengeful and an angry God. But the word Luke uses is the word, the Greek word metanoia, which is literally translated in to be convinced of another way, to change your mind, and in response to be transformed in your mind and heart, to change your actions. To repent means turning from going your one way, your way, the way you think is the right way because you always did it like this, or change brings trouble, or transformation is not necessary. I think you get the picture here. So to repent is turning from what you think is right to going God's way of searching for peace, justice, unity, and reconciliation. But of course, we are human. We have our own limitations, our own fears and weaknesses and struggles. We don't have to deny that, which is that we struggle and stumble and that we make mistakes, all of us. And sometimes we are quite messed up, all of us. And we can face the reality that we are imperfect human beings and not always capable of living up to God's vision, how this world really can be. Sometimes it feels like living in the wilderness or as a church, living at the edge of society. Are we still listened to? Does our word still have power? Do we proclaim visions of freedom and peace? Wilderness is not a place of desolation, but wilderness is a place of hope. Wilderness is always a transitional place, so to speak. A place where time is given to think about who we are as church and as church people, who we are today, what to give, and what to change, and who do we choose to be. So transitional time, the time we are in now, means that together we will think about who we are to be as a church in the 21st century, what to think about, how to change, within the traditions that are so very precious to us, and to proclaim the deep peace of God, and to help people to meet the face of Jesus when they come into this church. But you know, as we struggle in our ups and downs of dejection and hope, let me assure you that God's deep desire for restoration of the church, this church and every church, means that God is always trying to help us to make that happen. We are not alone. Because we are God's church. You are God's church. You are God's mission. We are God's mission. And we don't have to be celebrities or rulers or even pastors to be used and to be called by God. God is eager to use our talents, our abilities, and our gifts to change the world, even in what seems like very small ways, but in the big picture, they are huge. So we are called to remind each other that God is at work in and through our lives, each of your lives, for the sake of the world God loves so much. So we and you, the people of God, we are God's people in listening and serving and supporting each other. And with that, we participate in an ongoing movement of hope here at this place. We deliver hope. And in listening and in serving and supporting each other, we learn to trust each other and to change into people we are already in God's eyes. Do you trust me yet? I'm not sure, but I trust you, brothers and sisters in Christ, because we all are the body of Christ. We all are the sacred body of Christ's, and we belong together in good times and in bad times. So how can we bring Advent hope into the places of this land and this world where people are experiencing the profound absence of well-being and where there's even rejection and hostility? And you know there are many, many, many possibilities, and some of them you know already. We might choose to donate gifts to the many aid agencies who partner with communities to help other people overcome challenges right now, the people in Abbotsford and surrounding areas. We can also be encouraged to be a volunteer. For example, I learned yesterday that Meals on Wheels is urgently looking for volunteers, especially during Christmas times. We can make things with our own hands, as you do and did, and we can offer our own unique talents and gifts, as you do and did, and we can pray, always pray. And the other equally important question we together will journey towards is, how will we be church in the 21st century? What will we choose to be? How will we be water in the wilderness for others? And as I said, this is a journey together. This is a journey together, and on this journey, we will discover again and again God's guidance and God's love. Who will we choose to be? Let's find it out. This is a short sermon. I was told last time, oh, your sermon was quite short. And this is a short sermon as well, because I don't want to stay as longer at this place as necessary because of COVID. So, but these are the main words for me to you today. We are together in this. Let us together search for ways to be church in this time. What kind of church will we be? Will we be a safe place for everybody? Are you in this? Are you with me? So the word of the Lord came to John in the wilderness, and the word of the Lord came to us today. Like John, like the prophet and John the Baptist, may we become hope-filled voices in desolate places, preparing the way of the Lord for everyone and everybody. Amen. And the peace of God, which surpasses all of our understanding, may fill our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. God, thank you for being our God. Thank you for your guidance and the peace you wish us to have. Hear now our prayers. For the leaders and people of every nation, we pray. For the church and all who serve the Lord. For those who suffer in sorrow and affliction. For refugees and travelers far from home. For those whose lives have been so heavily impacted by the flooding and climate change. For all who are in prison or facing trial. For those who sit in darkness or the shadow of death. For youth and young people searching and yearning for meaning. Gracious God, this is our prayer, that your love will overflow more and more in our lives, in our church, and in all the world, until all may know the peace of Jesus, our Savior and brother and Lord, in whose name we pray. Amen. And together we pray in the language you are familiar with or acquainted with, German or English, the Lord's Prayer. Praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, geheiligt werde dein Name, dein Reich komme, dein Wille geschehe, wie im Himmel, so auf Erden. Unser tägliches Brot gib uns heute und vergib uns unsere Schuld, wie auch wir vergeben unseren Schuldigern. Und führe uns nicht in Versuchung, sondern erlöse uns von dem Bösen. Denn dein ist das Reich und die Kraft und die Herrlichkeit in Ewigkeit. Amen. So geht und seid im Frieden Gottes in dieser wunderbaren Adventszeit mit dem Segen Gottes. Der Herr segne dich und behüte dich. Der Herr lasse leuchten sein Angesicht über dir und sei dir gnädig. Der Herr erhebe sein Angesicht auf dich und gebe dir seinen Frieden. Amen.